Ora, bem-vindos a mais um vídeo de Starfield. Ora, vamos continuar as missões da facção Prestar Collective. Vamos ver se é agora que ganho a treta da nave. A Star Eagle. Acho que é assim o nome dela. Mas havia mais outro que aquele. Mas vai ser daquelas missões. outro. Agora, tenho aqui coisinhas para apanhar, coisinhas boas. A caveira está a 2000, ele está a 600. Vamos cá apanhar este. Agora apanhar este, está a 2000. Está quanto mais créditos, boa. Créditos. Acho que a caverna aqui é para aterrar. É ali. Ah, pois, era o tal Mac Factory. Oh! Então, vai outra vez para lá. Ver os skills que a gente tem. Só posso subir aqui mais alguma coisinha. Posso. Posso. Não. Também não. Tech science. Seat a nav. Fazer um savezinho. tinha que ser. Mas olha, tira bem a energia. Ai, tira. Vamos esconder aqui, está quieto. Inventário de aid para energia. Calhar. Não quer tombstone nenhuma. Ai, deixa ver se está aqui mais algum med pack. Acho que não. Ah, Não vou fazer este tipo de save. Vou fazer aqui. Melhor.
I'm a man of action. I've got no use for lies. So when I tell you that you're being manipulated, you know I'm telling the truth. You think the Council of Governors really cares about anything but themselves? They're greedy and corrupt. You're a tool in the hands of the unworthy. I was loyal. I followed orders, and I led good men and women to their deaths. I'll carry the stain of that dishonor to my grave.
Hostile in area.
Sabia que agora é save atrás de saves. Ela também não faz nada, não faz nada. Fica a olhar para mim. Mau, o que é que eu vi ali ao fundo? Aqui algo caído. Aqui, nada é medpacks. Muita coisa como quem diz, né? Alguma coisita para apanhar é de lixo. Nada é medpacks. Isto é, mas fica a ver se é.
Ah,
por aqui. Ver se eu consigo flanquear. E um. Menos um. Uma granadinha. Haver mais aí de volta três. Algum deles tem mais algum magpack.
Might as well take what we can.
Tinha um martelo. Deixa eu ver o que é para aí. Deveria ter acabado aqui também. Nada. Bem, fiz um savezinho outra vez.
The first cavalry was the greatest fighting force the Freestar Collective has ever seen.
Pá, mas tu não te calas, pá.
The first cavalry was destroyed. Why? Because the generals got scared and asked for a truce. I've got no sympathy for cowards or for the people who put them in power. I've also got...
Fita. O que é que eu disse? Meter à frente. Já sei o que é que vou fazer. Já sei o que vou fazer mesmo. Vais levar com as granadas, vais ver. Já não percebi. What? Só com esta treta de energia. Não vou lá, não. Mas tem que ser. Mas tem que ir. Não são mais chatos que eu. Acho foi. Acho eu. Tenho que achar uma maneira de ter energia. Porque não tenho nenhuma skill. Metem-me a arder porquê? Nem sequer me acertam. E vai lá. Deixa eu ver este gajo. Pena. Deixa-me ver aquele. Ops, vira. Vira aqui. estava a ver. Estava difícil.
Well, I suppose they're not going to need it anymore.
Olá. E agora tem um robô para lutar por mim. Tem aqui alguma coisa. Aqui um em cima, acho eu.
Find anything useful?
Let's do this.
Não tive tempo. Epa, sai da frente! Ah, tá, ela, puta da. Pá, bolas para raios dos NPCs, pá. Fazer uma pontaria de caraças, os gajos, pá. Porra. Pá, parece que tenho menos energia cada vez que faço revive. Revive não. Oh, porra. Thank you. Ah, tá, ela meteu-se à frente. Ali uma turret. Ali uma turret. Fogo. Consegue-me atingir entre os ferros. Caraças.
Smugglers would give their right arm to have a crack at those mech parts. Not sure what this connects to.
Command Center, deixa ver, o que é que eu vou encontrar aqui?
I can't believe the scope of the operation the FC was running here. It's a miracle that the fighting ended at all.
Thank you. collier par les membranes. Bah. Porre. Este gajo é mania de se meterem à frente, pá. Uma pessoa que está a disparar não consegue, pá.
Stock up on jump.
about time. Come on, sleepyhead.
Vamos lá. Já tenho energia no máximo. Vamos lá falar com ela. Tirei. Tenho por aqui. Já eu vou falar contigo. Tem calma aí que não vais lá dar nenhum. Pezinho. Isto preciso. Da cá. Vamos lá.
I can't believe it. You just took on some of the best mercenaries in the Freestar Collective and cut right through them. If we'd have had more like you in the war, we could have planted our flag in New Atlantis. Not the way it should have. Of course, I can't expect you to understand what we sacrificed, what we lost. You don't know what it's like to look around and see the faces of warriors who trusted you to lead them as they die screaming. I watched brave men and women torn limb from limb by monsters. I saw mech pilots cooked alive in their cockpits as their machines burned. Those deaths didn't have to be meaningless. But spineless leaders gave up on us, even when victory was within our grasp.
We've both seen our share of hell. It's whether or not we allow those awful memories to consume our souls that defines who we are.
You have no right to judge me. You really want to know? Because you might not like the answer. Last chance, deputy. You can walk away right now and remain blissfully ignorant, thinking you fight for a noble cause. But if you still want the truth, I'll shatter that illusion for you right now. We'll see about that. Not long after I started the first, I was contacted by a man who said he represented someone wealthy and influential. I refused to work for a shadow client, so we agreed to set up a meeting. Imagine my surprise when Ron Hope showed up. He offered me a lucrative contract to take possession of certain farms throughout Freestar space.
That's quite an accusation.
Sure I did. The money was good, but the payback was the real reward. If I could avenge my men, make some credits, and eventually expose a member of the council, well, that, my friend, is my definition of justice. Don't bother.
We're trying to take you in quietly. Violence is not the answer, Major.
I'm gonna make this easy for you, Deputy. I'm gonna die the way I lived. Weapon in hand, no compromise, no fear. But first, here, take this. Use it to cut out the weakness rotting at the heart of the Freestar Collective. When the next war comes, and it will come, the Collective needs to be strong. Now my unit's waiting for me, and I'm gonna report for duty one last time. Goodbye. deputy.
Aquele One, quem é? Era aquele que disse que não sabia nada.
Something useful here.
O que é que pegaste? Fica a ver. Fica cá. Fazes-me levantar. Se não for nada de jeito. Leva de uma estalada na Pai Natal. Pá. Posso ajudar?
Não é
mal. Não é
mal. Sure, go ahead.
Então, tens nada?
Time to go. Dizes
que tens e agora não tens nada. Oh, mau.
Volvo.
All right, that's it.
While we're here, we should swing by Hope Tech Star Yard and see if they have anything interesting for sale. For you.
From the Marshal about your problem. He said you had a promising lead on the mercenaries who stole my ship. I trust you're here with good news. Excuse me? You'd better have a damn good explanation for this. That's one hell of an accusation. That two-faced bastard kept the slate. Oh, I suppose this is his revenge against the Council of Governors for what happened during the war. I'm impressed, Deputy. It's clear you have a bright future ahead of you.
What's going on? What is this about, Mr. Hope?
Nothing that concerns you, Birgit. In fact, why don't you make yourself scarce?
I think I'd like to hear what the deputy has to say.
I can see you're upset. Allow me to explain. And you'll see that there were very good reasons for what I had to do. The truth is, we've been falling behind the competition. Significantly so. We needed solutions.
Ah, pois.
A few years ago,
we started to research chemicals to fuel those sort of things.
We developed an experimental fertilizer. And it failed utterly. It wiped out entire crops. I was prepared to write the whole thing off when we made a discovery that changed everything. Turns out, our fertilizer was transforming the soil, bolstering its mineral content tenfold. Mining is expensive, and so is the cost of raw materials. My mineral-enriching fertilizer solves several problems at once. The farmers provide free manual labor, and once the land is ready, we move in to extract and process the soil.
So those farmers poisoned themselves, and you ended up reaping profits. How can you even live with yourself?
It's nothing personal. It's just good business. I don't expect you to understand. Look, I'll level with you. We're falling behind the competition. The hardworking people of this town depend on me for their livelihoods, and I won't let them down. Cutting my costs means saving their jobs.
I can't believe what I'm hearing. How could you do something so awful to innocent people, to families?
Not another word out of you, Birgit. I can take your job. And more. We'll discuss this later. In any case, I suppose the gig is up. I give you my word that I'll call off the operation and return the land to its rightful owners. Like I said, I give you my word. Besides, with that resolved, as a member of the Council of Governors, and of course, we'll both agree to forget about my little cost-cutting endeavor. Well, let's not be too hasty, Deputy. There's something else you need to consider. I'll do what's necessary to protect my company and my employees. If you tell anyone about this, you're risking their livelihoods. Do you really want to put all these people out of work and make their families suffer? But on a much larger scale. Yes. Justice. Sometimes the cost of exacting justice is greater than the cost of doing nothing. I'll make myself. I won't let you jeopardize, if that means you suffer an I'm important!
You're not actually threatening to attack a Free Star Ranger, are you?
You're a despicable man, Hope. And I hope you get exactly what you deserve.
Such a shame to see a promising career cut so trench.
The wrong line.
To have you killed. I don't understand. Mr. Hope always seemed like such a good person. But everything he said about the farmers and hiring those mercenaries, it was so awful. The first part is true. He always looked out for us, for his employees. No, of course not. But there was more to him than that. He had a genuinely good side, a caring side. And now he's... You. You killed him. Nobody should ever want that. Especially when it means killing someone who meant so much to so many people. What happens to us now? That would be Elana. Elana Nwankwo. She seems pretty capable. Maybe we'll be okay after all. I guess we'll have to figure things out. Find a path forward.
There might be some difficult days ahead, but I wish you good luck.
Sorry, fick jag sen betrygen mot män. Och dess. Ämsla.
Just waiting on the credit check.
Este episódio já está a ser um bocadinho grande. Vamos só falar lá com o Major Blake. Ver o que é que acontece.
We'd be dust.
Off worlders.
Always something going on
fun. Now what?
Ready here. Doors good too.
I have something for you when you have a moment. I have an important personal decision to make, but I need to discuss something with you first. Phew, thank you. So, where to start? Before I was with the Navigator Corps, I was career military, part of the United Colonies Navy. When the colony war broke out, I was posted as the chief navigator on a warship, the Dauntless. Well, the position didn't last long. There was a particularly bloody battle. We were fighting over a world in the Aether Cassiopeia system. Worst fighting I'd ever seen. We lost 12 ships that day. 12. Including my own. No. This is important. I need to tell you this. The ship was barely intact. The captain and first mate died the previous day, which put me in command. A shrewd captain would have called for the crew to abandon ship. But I was so angry. I wanted to stay. I needed to fight. I believe you. But you haven't heard the worst of this. We fought for hours, but the damage was fatal. I gave the order to abandon ship, and the crew piled into the escape shuttle. As the shuttle launched, I could see it was damaged. I heard screams before the radio cut. The last thing I saw, they were spiraling helplessly towards the planet's surface. There was nothing I could do. You're sorry for me? If I hadn't been so stubborn, so eager to prove that I could handle command, my crew would have had more time to escape. Try telling that to their loved ones. When the dust settled, the United Colonies gave me a medal. Can you believe that? A damn medal. I never even had a chance to find the shuttle wreckage and give my crew a proper burial. That's true, but still, doesn't erase the real issue here. Remember when you said no one but me would have pushed harder to keep the Navigator Corps going? Well, this time, pushing too hard cost lives. Don't you get it? Everything I do, everything I touch, somehow falls apart. That's why I'm worried about us. After everything you've heard, all my stories, you still have faith. No one's ever cared about me this much. Not even Asha. You know, I've spent a lot of time thinking about us, about our relationship, how we've clearly become close. I practiced what I was going to say when the moment was right, and now that it's here, my mind's gone blank. Look, you deserve the best. Someone who can give themselves to you entirely. But right now, I have too much baggage. Too much on my mind. I hope you'll forgive me for pushing you away. I just need time.
Bem, vamos lá falar com o Marshall.
Good to see you back safe, Deputy. What's the word on the mech factory? Were the mercenaries hiding out there? I take it that they weren't too much trouble for you, given that you're standing here. Did you find out why the First was taking over farms? What? Ron Hope? That's one hell of an accusation, Deputy.
Are you really that surprised? Hope's always had a reputation as a man who'd do anything to succeed.
He's on the damn council, Emma.
so he can make laws favorable to his business interests. Sure, he's known to look after his people, but do you really think he gives a damn about some farmers on Montara Luna?
Did Hope explain his motives at all? That has a familiar ring to it.
I recall hearing about some Hope Tech initiative to help farmers. At the time, I just figured it was a PR stunt. Seems a little more sinister now.
Please, tell me you've got some evidence to back up these extraordinary claims. All right, let's see what you've got. Interesting. Yeah, this is pretty damning. Especially this last bit about destroying the slate. And you confronted Hope about this? Sounds like his pride got the best of him. Damn. This is going to send shockwaves throughout the Free Star Collective. If the people can't trust their leaders, anarchy could follow.
Have a little faith, Daniel. We're not the United Colonies. One bad apple won't spoil the whole damn barrel.
Easy for you to say. You ain't the Marshal.
Not yet, but you ain't gonna live forever, old man.
While we've got you here, there's one last piece of business to take care of. Emma, would you please?
With pleasure, Marshal. When you first joined us, I told you that you'd undergo an evaluation process. There's one thing left to do. A simple question. Do you feel ready to wear the badge of a full-fledged Free Star Ranger? Good. Duty and honor are the backbone of the Free Star Rangers. Marshal, I approve the deputy for advancement to the rank of Ranger.
Thank you, Ranger Wilcox. In your time serving as a deputy, you've shown exceptional courage, fearless tenacity, and a high regard for the safety of our citizens. By the authority granted to me by the Council of Governors, I hereby promote you to the rank of Ranger. Here's your badge. Wear it with pride. But don't forget the solemn responsibility it represents.
Thanks to my own personal biases against the Free Star Collective, I was skeptical when you originally accepted the appointment. But seeing you in this moment, I have to admit that I am bloody proud of you. Well done.
You've shown that faith was well placed. Let's hear it for our new Ranger.
Achievement.
The promotion.
Vamos lá ver a nave. Rented room é onde? Zegt haar naam. É isto que eu quero. Onde é que está a Star Eagle? Quero a Star Eagle.
I picked up something you might be interested in. What can I help you with? Yes, have a look. Goodbye.
Continuamos no próximo episódio. Obrigado por verem. Subscrevam, caso não o tenham feito ainda. E deixem o vosso like. Obrigado.